Let me ask you a question. What was the backstage? What was the deal with when they brought all those NXT guys up a month ago or so, whatever it was, and they brought them all up at one time, no vignette, no nothing, just threw them out there on the show. Was there a backstory why they did that, like with Vince and Hunter or something?
Vince woke up one day and goes, "We need some new guys. Who's really good there?" I mean, he had guys that Hunter was doing a feud with, and brought him up as a tag team because he didn't care. So he brought who he thought or who's told were the top four guys there, and he brought him up right away because that week we need new faces, and we need to have these new faces win every time. So he spent and you know what ends up happening is you get it was Gargano, Ciampa, Black, and Ricochet. So Ciampa gets hurt right away because he's already injured, and it was in hindsight a terrible move to bring him up when his neck was so messed up. Then they decide without Ciampa, we don't want Gargano. So Gargano's now off TV after a bunch of wins. So you're left with Black and Ricochet, who they kept winning. You know, they kept having them win constantly. And then they split up them, and now, you know, I don't know what's going to happen with them as a single. I mean, Ricochet lost to Bobby Roode. That tells me that you know, they were Vince's shiny new toys, and now he's looking for new toys. And
after a month.
Well, not just that. He did absolutely nothing to get him over. First of all, he introduced him like a bunch of just anybody out of, you know, I know it was a last minute decision, but the way they were introduced was so bland and so, you know, uninspiring.
It's like they're introduced like a football team coming out. Like, here's the quarter. You're like, you're announcing the guy. Bro, you know, he's running through the bed, just ran out of the show, you know?
Here's the other part. Dave, if you were like a fan that hadn't watched WWE in a while and you didn't know what the fuck NXT was, and you were watching Ricochet for the first time, you'd have no idea this is like the most gifted wrestler, you know, high flyer since Rey Mysterio. He's not really doing anything. And even, and I like Aleister Black, but even when they were giving the hot tag, they were giving it to Black, not to Ricochet. And this happened like three times, not once.
Yeah.
It's like everything was so, you know, done wrong from the very beginning, and then they lose confidence, and then when these guys aren't getting over immediately, well, yeah, you didn't put them in a position to get over either.
Yep. And then they don't, and then it becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy. And the thing is that if you're put in there with middle guys, the people think you're a middle guy. If you're put in there with... See, now, the thing they're doing with Lacey Evans, they're trying a different approach, because with her, they're putting her in there with the top girl right away.
Yeah,
right.
That never works either. That never works. That always
I'll throw a prediction.
6 weeks from now, she'll just be in the middle of the card wrestling Ruby Riott and stuff. The way they book. They don't. Here's what they do. And like me and Tony have talked about this. They repeat all the time in the show. They have a very clever way of burying people. They start getting you over a little bit. And then you literally hit the glass ceiling, but the glass ceiling is way lower than where you think it should be. And they literally just bury people.